Myself Shelly Pathania, working as assistant professor in the Department of Pharmaceutical Chemistry at ISF College of Pharmacy, Moga. On the behalf of ISF College, I welcome you all in our e-lab series session. Today we are going to perform a practical of medicinal chemistry B form 4 semester with my colleague Ms. Amarjit Kaur.
Hello friends.
The aim of the practical is to synthesize phenytoin from benzyl and urea. So let us start with phenytoin. Phenytoin is an example of anticonvulsant drug. It is chemically known as 5,5-diphenyl-2,4-imidazolidine diode. You can see in the structure that this 5-member ring is known as imidazolidine, and at 5 and 5' position there are two phenyl ring, and at 2nd and 4th position there are two carbonyl group present. So the chemical name of the structure is 5,5-diphenyl-2,4-imidazolidine diode, or in simple way you can say phenytoin. The chemical reaction utilized for the synthesis of phenytoin is pinacol rearrangement reaction. In this reaction, it is a base catalyzed reaction occurring between the benzyl and urea. The reaction proceeds by intramolecular cyclization to form an intermediate pinacol, which on acidification in the presence of dilute HCl solution, which produce phenytoin as a product. Actually, what happened during the rearrangement reaction, there is a 1,2 diphenyl shift in the pinacol rearrangement, which ultimately leads to the formation of phenytoin. The mode of the action of phenytoin is that it mainly acts by binding to the voltage dependent sodium ion channel, which inhibit the entry of sodium ions inside the neurons. This ultimately inhibit the repetition generation of action potential and ultimately prevent the discharge of seizure. So we can say that it is used to control the seizure, or it is used as an anti-epileptic drug. For this experiment, the glassware required are round bottom flask, measuring cylinder, beaker, funnel, reflex condenser, glass rod, and the droppers. The chemicals required are benzyl, urea, ethanol, sodium hydroxide, that is 30% weight by volume, and hydrochloric acid. And a weighing machine is required for weighing the sample. For the safety precaution, always remember that lab coat, mask and gloves should be properly wear during the experiment, and make sure that all the glassware should be clean, rinsed and dried properly. The procedure is, first of all, take 2 gram of benzyl and transfer it to the round bottom flask. Then take 1.2 gram of urea and add it to round bottom flask. Now add 10 ml of ethanol to the round bottom flask. Mix well. Now add 10 ml of 30% aqueous sodium hydroxide solution to the RBF. Attach the RBF to the reflex condenser and boil the content for 2 hours. After 2 hours, take off the RBF . Transfer the reaction mixture to the beaker and allow it to cool on ice bath condition. Now add 10 ml of cold water to the reaction mixture and allow it cool for some time. After some time, you will see that there is a formation of byproduct in the reaction mixture. To remove this byproduct, filter the content with the help of funnel. After the filtration, acidified the filtrate using 20% HCl in order to get pH around 2. Add HCl drop by drop to the beaker. Check the pH. Now filter out the precipitated product with the help of funnel. And the crude phenytoin is obtained. You can recrystallize this crude phenytoin by using ethanol. Calculation: how to calculate the percentage yield of the crude product? First of all, you have to calculate the theoretical yield. To calculate the theoretical yield, the 1 mole of benzyl is equivalent to 1 mole of phenytoin. That means the molecular weight of the benzyl is equivalent to the molecular weight of phenytoin. Let us suppose here the molecular weight of benzyl is 210 gram, that is equivalent to the 252 gram of phenytoin. Now 1 gram of benzyl is equivalent to x gram of phenytoin, and in the practical we have take 2 gram of phenytoin. So that means to calculate the x, we have to divide the molecular weight of phenytoin by the molecular weight of benzyl into 2 gram. The molecular weight of the phenytoin is here 252 gram and the molecular weight is 210 gram, and the quantity that we have taken, that is 2 gram. So by calculating it, it become 2.38 gram. Now this 2.38 gram is the theoretical yield. The practical yield is calculated by weighing the crude phenytoin. Let us suppose it comes at 5 gram. Then to calculate the percentage yield, we have to put the formula practical yield divided by theoretical yield into 100. Put the value of practical yield and theoretical yield and multiply by 100, and you will get the percentage yield of the phenytoin. Thanks for watching.
I hope you